Well, right now, that's the countdown clock. It's probably bringing some mixed emotions for people across Minnesota tonight. In less than 10 hours, tens of thousands of Minnesota kids will return to class. But they will be heading back with fewer teachers and support staff because of a nationwide shortage. Danny is back now to show us how districts are getting creative in the classroom to deal with these challenges.
Labor Day weekend is always the last hurrah before school starts.
Teachers are back into the workshop setting in school districts. Bus drivers are getting ready to drive the bus. They're learning their routes.
Longtime educator Deb Hinton knows the feeling well.
It's an exciting time.
But as the executive director of the Minnesota Association of School Administrators, Hinton foresees challenges.
I can tell you that there is a real staffing shortage. What you hear is true. You know, many districts are still working to fill positions.
Support staff, special education, science and math are among the areas of concern.
I can tell you that I heard just last week of an elementary teacher that's going to be teaching science classes and of a principal that's going to be teaching as well. So it's all hands on deck.
But the state's largest districts have made some progress on hiring. St. Paul Public Schools told us they've dropped their teacher openings from 138 in mid-August to 80 entering Labor Day weekend. In Minneapolis, that number dropped from 280 to 255. Anoka-Hennepin had 450 total positions open at the start of the summer and now have fewer than 175.
We need to really let people know what a great profession it is. It's a noble profession.
Despite the shortages, many districts told us they're comfortable with the staff they have heading into the year, although families can expect some adjustments.
In some cases, class sizes may have to rise if there's not enough teachers. Our superintendents and our principals are working really hard to make sure they find the people that are necessary to fill the classrooms.
Well, for some districts, teacher shortages aren't the issue, but rather before and after school staff. Stillwater, for example, told us they're having trouble finding custodians and nutrition services workers. Well, this new school year also marks a return to more normalcy when it comes to COVID. All children 6 months and over are now eligible for the vaccine, but it is not required in Minnesota schools. The state's three biggest districts, Minneapolis, St. Paul, and Anoka-Hennepin, have all dropped the mask and social distancing requirements as well. All the districts say they'll be flexible to changing state or federal guidance.